Chào mừng quý vị và các bạn đến với chương trình Tôi và Việt Nam trên kênh truyền hình FBNC. Và ngày hôm nay thì chúng tôi muốn quý vị tìm hiểu một dự án thú vị liên quan đến giáo dục, một dự án khởi nghiệp tại Mỹ, đó là trường đại học Minerva. Đây là một dự án mới và với tham vọng sẽ thay đổi nền giáo dục toàn cầu. Ngày hôm nay chúng tôi rất hân hạnh được mời đến trường quay anh Ken Ross, là giám đốc khu vực châu Á của trường học Minerva, nhân chuyến công tác đến Việt Nam để giúp chúng ta tìm hiểu thêm về mô hình thú vị này. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
So Minerva University, you told me this is going to be a reimagined university that tried to reform the whole global education and changing U.S. education system. That sounds very ambitious.
Quite.
I'm curious. So what do you mean by that? What is Minerva?
So basically, Minerva, in a nutshell, as we say, is a reimagined university, you got it right, for the brightest and most motivated students around the world. So we say reimagined because we are doing many things differently than, say, other top traditional universities.
How different?
In many cases, very, very different, actually,
okay.
But different with a purpose. Listen, Minerva was created, was conceived by a number of prominent educators in the United States who believe, who know that U.S. higher education needs to reform. It needs to be better. And this is interesting because many people from around the world, particularly outside of the United States, believe that maybe U.S. higher education is, if not perfect, maybe close to it.
In the top of mind of the Vietnamese parents and students, U.S. education is only number one.
Right, and maybe relatively speaking, right, that may be the case. Maybe we dare to say it is better maybe than higher education here or in some other places. But even if that's the case, that does not necessarily mean that it's good enough. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's good absolutely, and it doesn't necessarily mean that it's good enough, right? And so people, including former presidents and deans of Stanford, of Harvard, of Wharton, of McGill in Canada, schools like this, these are people that have come together that either are currently or in the past have been part of Minerva in some capacity and believe that there's so many things that we actually can do better. You know, for example, right now, curriculum, basically. The curricula that are used at many of the top schools, I mean, as you know, I went to Harvard, which is a good traditional, I think, university. The curriculum at many of these types of schools has been the way it's been for many, many years. I have relatives who went to that same school several decades before me, taking very similar type of curriculum. So the need for much more modern, much more rigorous curriculum, right, is very, very much needed. The need to improve the way we teach, not only what we teach,
how,
which is curriculum, but how we teach, the way we teach, right, is very, very much needed. There are decades worth of data and research that have been done that we have about how best to teach people, right? For example, we know, I'd say it's a fact, that people learn best in an environment of when you only have maybe 15 to 18 students in a room, where it's a discussion, either teacher-led, usually professor-led, it could be student-led, but professor-led is probably better. That's the type of environment in which people learn the most.
Okay.
They go back, they've watched a lecture on their own, they've read the book on their own, and they come together and they discuss. It's interactive, right? Not big lectures. The reality is that people don't learn very well in big lecture classes.
But a lot of schools doing that too.
You know why that is, right? It's a good, from a school's perspective, it's a great business model. It's a great way to run a school. If I have one professor up there who I pay however much money, and 500 students who are all paying tuition, that's great scalability, that's a great business model. It's a great way to teach, or it's a great way to run a school, it's a horrible way to learn. And basically everybody knows this. This is not, I think all of us, you know, you've been in many hours of class in your life, so have I. We all know, anecdotally speaking, from our own experience that this is not the case. But basically because, sometimes because it's maybe a better business model, or sometimes just because it's the way that people have operated for many, many years, this is still the way it's done. It can be improved, it can be made better. So these are two ways, for example, that you can definitely improve upon things.
How can you make a difference with the traditional learning style? How do you make a difference at Minerva?
There are two major ways. One is relatively simple and straightforward. The other way is can be somewhat complex. So at Minerva, 100% of classes, every single class you go into, never has more than 19 students.
Okay.
Never.
Less than 19 people?
And that is, there's no other university on the planet that I know of who can actually say that. And why do we do that? Because we know something called the science of learning, which is basically the study of the way we learn, which tells us after many, many years of data and research that that's the best way to learn. That's the environment which is best to learn. In addition, We also have something, we use technology in a way that is very, very purposeful and very, very structured, and quite like anything, unlike anything that anyone has ever done before, we have this interactive, online, live technology platform through which students take all their regular classes. So 100% of classes are actually conducted through this platform. Now, this is not technology just for technology's sake. Okay. It's not because it's fun. It's quite cool, I have to say, but that's not the idea. The idea is we actually are now at a critical stage of development in technology where it can be used for certain educational purposes. Specifically, it can be used to improve your classroom experience and optimize individual student learning outcomes. That's a key term, optimize those individual student learning outcomes. We can track people. Well, imagine if you have a classroom, a virtual classroom experience. Again, it's a small class. It's only 15 or 19 people. It's live. It's highly interactive. Everybody is right there in the front row. You cannot hide. It's intense for those of us who've experienced it. And I encourage people to, you know, maybe this is something you'd like to try someday. It's very, very intense. Like, you have to be on the ball and on your game, so to speak, for the entire period of the class. But the idea is to be able to track students' learnings for the professor, other professors, advisors, to be able to go back and see how students are performing in class, how they're actually applying what they're supposed to learn on a daily basis, right? And then what we call scaffolding this, right? To make the entire 4 years integrated such that what you learn in year one, right? And certainly these, the core, not only do we train in actual content knowledge, we actually have a big focus on core key skills, like the ability to think critically, think creatively, and communicate effectively. We teach these purposely and in a structured way, again, unlike any other school. But we can track how people are learning and how they can apply these habits of mind, these concepts, these skills, or how they can actually apply content knowledge that they learn throughout the entire 4 years of school, because everything is tracked and everything is recorded.
Thank you. Long story short, at Menever, you have a blended model, which is combine the online thing with the offline teaching.
So Menever, basically student activities or students' lives, you can say, while at Menever can be broken up into maybe three different types of activities. There's the curricular activities, which are courses, and let's just call homework also curricular activities. All of the courses are all done through our online platform, even though students are living around the world together in residence halls. Students are together, it's a residential university, but because we want to optimize individual student learning outcomes and because we can use the technology to do so, everyone takes class through the platform.
But there's still professors, though.
Of course there are professors. There have to be professors.
But you take online class, like, because you take it in advance and then you come to class and do discussion with the professor. Right?
No, basically you will have homework or you have stuff that you do on your own, of course, but when you come to class, through the class, all classes are through this technology platform, through our active learning forum, as we call the platform, right? In addition to classes, of course, there will be some work, group work, homework, that is going to be done offline, that is going to be done locally, whether students are living in San Francisco, whether they're going to be living in other, they do live in seven different other cities and countries during the course of their time at Menever. Talk about that in a second, but basically, so there are offline activities that are curricular involved. There are also something what we call co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities are, for the most part, offline activities that are done locally. They are meant to augment and expand upon the curriculum. And in addition to that, there are also extracurricular activities, right? Both student, school-organized extracurricular activities like clubs and activities and sports, and then there are also things that students are just going to want to do on their own. So it's a very, very dynamic sort of type of experience that people actually have. And right now, of course, we have our founding class of students who are in there, have already started their first year in San Francisco taking this, and they can attest, and if people actually, maybe they can get in touch with some of these students and they can even ask what their experience is like. It's pretty dynamic, pretty
intense. I'll get back to that after a short break.
Certainly.
Thank you so much for sharing a lot of good information. Thưa quý vị, vừa rồi là chia sẻ của anh Ken Ross, là giám đốc của khu vực châu Á của trường đại học Menever, một dự án khởi nghiệp về giáo dục với tham vọng là sẽ thay đổi nền giáo dục toàn cầu. Quý vị có thể xem lại chương trình này trên website fbnc.vn hoặc là facebook.com/tôi về Việt Nam. Chúng tôi sẽ còn quay trở lại sau ít phút nữa.